Hey guys, hello and welcome to Zen Innovations. And a few weeks back I made quite a few nice videos on stabilizer, and all of those videos are waiting for you in the description below and you can check those links. Now I have reviewed those stabilizers and the videos are in Hindi and English, and after that I also made a video regarding how you can use that stabilizer to safeguard your solar inverter or even a normal inverter, and along with that you can safeguard lot of sensitive devices in your home using just one stabilizer. So go ahead and check them out. But today's video is very interesting. Now one question popped up in my mind is that, well, this stabilizer might be having some kind of idle draw. Now that is the case that which we have seen in the inverter over here, and I have tested the idle draw of 12 volt and 24 volt inverter. The videos again will be waiting in description for you. So I thought, well, first thing is let's check the idle draw of this stabilizer. And the second thing is, does this use of stabilizer add some kind of conversion loss, or you can say some kind of efficiency loss when we power our devices through them? So let's say that I have a particular device consuming 500 watts, and if those 500 watts are being drawn through that stabilizer, does the actual load increase? So does the 500 watt device become 600 watts magically? In a simple language, you can say that, is there any kind of conversion loss which is happening inside a stabilizer? Alright guys, so let's go to the stabilizer and let's begin the testing process. Guys, welcome to the first part of testing, which would be idle draw or self power consumption. So here I have this stabilizer with me. And as you see, it has a lot of components. For example, it has this display, it has this fan, it has a huge transformer inside. And even when absolutely no load is connected, you can see this is the output section of the stabilizer and nothing is connected over here. During those times, still, it is going to consume some amount of power to keep all of this running. So this thing is known as idle power consumption. So let me turn this thing on. And by the time this meters and this time delay function will stabilize, I'll explain you the flow of power. So the power comes from here, from the wall socket. Actually, this comes from your pocket because you pay for it, right? So the power comes from here. It goes into this little power meter. And guys, if you want to buy this kind of power meter, this stabilizer or anything shown in this video, there will be a lot of buying links in description below. Please consider using my affiliate links. So the power comes over here, and this stabilizer had this huge 16 ampere socket which was not going to fit over here. So what I had to do is run a bit of jugaad. Guys, you please stay away from these kind of jugaads. You can let me know what kind of testing you want and I'll get it done for you. So the power comes here, the meter measures it, and it comes over here and it goes into the stabilizer. So this is the power cord and it goes into the stabilizer, and here nothing is connected, which means that the power is just being used to keep this machine alive. And how much power does it need to stay alive? Well, as good as 12 watts. So we can say that somewhere between 10, 15 or 20 watts your stabilizer is going to consume, depending on the model. This is a regular model which is usually intended for 1.5 ton AC. If you have a larger or smaller model, this might vary. But yeah, 12 or 15 watts is what I'm going to stay. And for all of you, those are lazy couch potatoes over there who use the remote to, you know, turn off the AC like that and they keep this thing powered, this is what you guys are wasting. So this power is worth, I'll say, having two LED bulbs constantly running, and your 12 watts over here are being simply wasted. So after you are done with the use of your AC or any home appliance which you have connected to your stabilizer, use the remote to turn it off. After the AC shuts down, what you do is get up and simply do this. All right. So that is going to help you save those 12, 15, 20 watts of your stabilizer. So now what I'll do is I'll move towards the phase two of testing, which is the efficiency. For that, I'll have to change this setup. You guys go there down below and hit those nice little like and subscribe buttons. Let's change the setup. Guys, welcome back. And for the phase two of this testing, I needed something which was a well-known load. So good old incandescent bulbs. On paper here, they are 60 watt each. I don't know if you can read them. It says very faintly over here. So each of these is 60 watts, and let's just measure them for good accuracy. So here they go. And yeah, good old golden old-fashioned light. Very outdated today, but yeah, they are fine for testing purposes. And the combined power consumption of these old guys is 138 watts. So there's slight difference in what is mentioned over here on these glass globes. And in actuality, it says 138 watts. We can see that this Mr. Stabilizer is sleeping and it is completely disconnected from this picture. So now what I'll do is I'll put this stabilizer in between the meter and the load, and then we'll see what kind of additional commission, what additional power does this thing consume while delivering the power to these guys. So let's change the setup that way. Okay guys, we are back with the renewed wiring, and the wiring is something like this. So we have the power meter and finally we have this load, but here in between we have this Mr. Commission agent who needs a bit of power, a bit of commission to pass the electricity over here. How much will that be? Well, let's measure it by using this button. So the flow of energy has now started something like this. It's going to go over here and then here, and the stabilizer comes with a time delay function. I've already explained all of these small niceties in this review video over here. You can go ahead and check it out. And yes, the load has started working. And let's check out what kind of power loss did we have to face by putting this stabilizer in between the source and the load. So the meter is now saying 147 or 148 watts. So we can say that, yeah, roughly 10 watts extra is what this thing consumed for passing the power. And whatever this figure would be in percentage as an efficiency, I'll put it over here. You can read it after the calculations. And yes, one thing I'd like to remind you is that, guys, this kind of power consumption, 100 or 150 watts, is a child's play for this kind of stabilizer. This is an AC stabilizer. So if I find a heavier load, then I'll try putting all of those measurements in the extra content section. You may want to watch the video completely without skipping. So that's it for this neat little video, guys. I hope you like seeing very exquisite experiments, something like this. So make sure to hit that subscribe button, also that like button, and also the share button down below. Take care and have a nice day, guys. All right, guys. So I got a hold of this induction cooktop, which will put some significant load on this stabilizer, because I wanted to see how will this perform and what efficiency we see at a higher current draw. So let's turn this thing on and let the meter stabilize. And by the way, guys, if you're interested in seeing very detailed power consumption test of this induction cooktop, then I have a video over here in the I button or in the description below. The videos are in Hindi and English. You can go ahead and check it out. We have tested all of these different modes. Okay, so the meters are on. This is at zero. And what I'm going to do is before putting this commission agent in between, we'll run a raw test so that we can see the power consumption of this induction cooktop. And I'm going to go to the medium setting over here, which is 1300. So let's turn it on and let's go to the 1300 setting, this one. So it is 180 degrees or 1300 watts. And here we can see the thing has already started boiling over. And the power consumption we see over here is roughly somewhere around 1200 watts. Let's check the amperage. So the amperage is 4.7 amps. Let me turn on the flash for you so you can see better. So 4.6, 4.7 amps it is. And the wattage draw is 1195. I'll just call it 1200 for the sake of remembering. So now what we have to do is just put this thing in between and then we can find out the efficiency of this stabilizer. All right, let's do it. I have connected the stabilizer in between. So let's turn this thing on, and until the time these meters stabilize and the time delay function happens, let me explain you the wiring. So the wiring is the good old same method which we had in the past. So the power comes in, it goes to this watt meter. I have an amp meter over here to show the amp draw as well. And the power first goes to this stabilizer like this via these thick cables. And then it comes out over here in the stabilized format. And after that, it provides power to this induction cooktop. You can check out the voltages are the same. So it was 240, 242, something like that. So same testing methodology over here. And now let's turn this thing on and let's compare if this Mr. Commission agent has a very high cost of commission or if he's a good guy and we can just use him. not a problem. Okay, so let's turn this thing on and I'll bring it back down to the 1300, which is the setting we used last time. And on this setting, the actual power consumption of this induction without the use of stabilizer was somewhere around 1200 watts. I'll just let it stabilize a bit. And here we can see that the amp draw is as good as similar to the last test. So that was 4.7 or 4.8 amps. And the wattage draw is very surprising. So 1223 watts. I'll say just 1220 watts over here. And here we can see that the stabilizer is now working. And this is the wattage consumption, 1226. Okay, let me pause this and then we can talk. So this test has really surprised me, and the efficiency of this stabilizer is beyond my expectations. So here what we are currently seeing is that without the presence of the stabilizer, the consumption of this induction cooktop on the same settings was somewhere around 1200, or I guess if I remember correctly, that was 1206, 1206 watts. And after putting this guy in between, the consumption we saw was 1220 or 1221, something like that. So the amount of increase was just 12 or 15 watts. And if you remember, in the first phase of the testing, we tested the idle consumption of this stabilizer, which was 12 or 15 watts. And this is just the increase which we saw over here. So in this test, I can conclude that the stabilizers are surprisingly efficient, and I have absolutely no problem recommending them to you. They're not going to increase the electricity bill. Yeah, it will go up by 10 or 15 watts, but the amount of protection they offer to your expensive electronic gadgets, your air conditioners, your computers, is so big that I would be very happy to pay the price of these 12 or 15 watts extra for running this stabilizer. And by the way, guys, if you are looking to buy a stabilizer for your home, then I have a dedicated video over here. The video is on my newer channel. Make sure you go ahead, check it out. You also subscribe it. And there we have compared various models of stabilizers for your different home appliances, be it air conditioners or TVs or anything like that. So you can go ahead and check it out. I'll leave all the links for these videos in the description section below. So to conclude, what I can say is that yes, I can absolutely recommending use of stabilizers for your home appliances. The benefit of protection is far larger than any kind of power loss which we see on these particular meters. So that was it for this little testing, guys. I hope you liked it. Take care and have a nice day.